Fox. Now Fox, Fox. Copy, Fox now.
Zweimal ganz aus. Was ist jetzt passiert?
All okay? It's all okay? It's all okay?
I know, yeah, I told him on the radio I need 5 minutes, man.
Ah, okay.
So I said it, but nobody's listening to me.
Spa-Francorchamps, what more can we say? It is an epic venue, 7 kilometres long, near enough, and brilliant that we can be here this weekend.
I love Spa. It's probably my favourite racetrack. But that weekend, I felt a lot of elements to deal with.
Enjoy it, man.
Thanks, brother.
We started with the first practice session. Yeah, everybody go out to get a rhythm, how the track situation is, how the balance is.
Four, engine up, four.
Copy.
The first day wasn't the quickest, but it was the normal start, and we thought, okay, second day will be better.
Radio check, 1, 2, 3, loud and clear.
Just traction. Traction was a bit the issue.
The Friday dramatically changed somehow, because both Felipe and Michael weren't happy with the balance of the car anymore.
Traction is worse. On the way out, it's still there.
In the debrief that we always do on that day, things got a little intense. Michael expressed his feelings, and I was quite surprised by what he had to say.
I know I got offline a couple of times, but the back left me, you know, when I put my foot down on the throttle there, it was so sketchy. But, you know, I think, like, the major issue for me is I just need to test more. I feel like I'm on the edge all the time. Why am I so exhausted when I get out of the car? Because I'm dealing with brand new things all the time. I'm out of my lead, you know. This is such a massive step for me. So like every time I'm going out of the car, maybe I get one good run and I do a set of good laps. But it's always like 50-50, you know. Then I go out, it's also edgy. And I'm like, am I gonna fucking bin it here? Or am I gonna keep it on the, you know, it's just, like I said, way too many elements to be dealing with for the first time in a high stress scenario.
Let's not be too depressive, right?
No, I'm not being depressive. No, I'm just being realistic. I understand your position, but it's not depressive, it's realistic.
Yeah, I understand that, but like, realistic, though. Michael, all I'm saying is to discuss this after a session where you weren't happy. It wasn't the same for him, and it was the same for him.
Let's discuss it together. Tonight, for now, let's just focus on the debriefing. Then we prepare you for the Bronx test, and tonight, or whatever.
Well, let's discuss it. We're here now. We'll wait when the engineers come in, we can start talking about it. But we're here now. Let's discuss it. This is what it's all about, you know.
Of course, you saw on the emotions from him that it was serious and he was not joking. And I mean, it was clear to everybody we have to take care now.
I'm not being depressive at all. I just know my own limits and where I'm at. And each time I get into the car, I'm at my limit, you know. And I'm searching for the connection to the car while I'm doing all these races. You know, it's just not enough seat time. You know, going to
pressure.
Well, it's not pressure. Look, we keep talking about pressure. It's not pressure. It's practice. You know, anything that you do in life, it's about practice. And this is my second time in Spa. It's kind of crazy.
I felt like I was ill-prepared, that I was not going to be ready to race on the Sunday there.
You know, it's just practice. It's not pressure. Pressure is always going to be there. Pressure is there for everyone. It's about seat time and practice.
So we will give you more time.
Cool.
You do the qualifying, you do the bronze test, you get the new tires in the practice session.
I'm not talking about it a race weekend.
No, but to maximum now the time and the confidence for you is to give you a good car. The only time you will have a good car is with new tires. And it will be in the next practice session, it will be in the bronze test, it will be in qualifying. In qualifying you have no LMP. You're alone with your car. You have the best track with less traffic, with low fuel, with new tires. Let's build up your confidence. I don't give a shit if I qualify or not.
Talking about extra seat time is not putting him into the car for one more session on a Friday afternoon. What we're actually talking about is do extra test days.
Obviously, we couldn't go and do a test at that point, but we had seat time over the 3 days that we had at the track. So he said, okay, well, let's give you more seat time.
I think the championship is the correct championship. We just need to build up your confidence and that everything is getting normal for you. And this is only happening by doing the championship. The step what you did was big. I said it also in Le Castellet, it was a big step. But it's a manageable step. And it's a step where you drive a lot, where you have a lot of seat times. And in the race, if you drive 2 hours, there's not many race series where you drive more than this.
I kind of felt that, okay, now we have to take this serious and give him as many laps as he needs or as it's possible, you know.
Richie came up with a plan and he said, okay, you know what, I don't need that seat time. I know Spa and I'm comfortable enough to go into the race. Let's just give that seat time to Michael and Felipe.
Richie sacrificed his seat time for me. Then Felipe backed up and, you know, also said, look, I've been to the track before. I know the track. I haven't raced the RSR here, but take more of my seat time as well.
I'll start with one.
Yes.
And see how it goes.
You know, if you change your three, do it for at least 2 laps.
Okay.
Ready, check 1, 2, 3. Check, check.
After Arouche, not on that three.
Michael, throttle position. Three.
Try to break later.
In turn 10, pull home.
Was ist er im Durchschnitt gefahren im Vergleich zu den anderen?
Eine Sekunde, ne? Sekunde. Ja.
Michael realized, okay, I need more seat time, but qualifying is not going to do that. Pressure in qualifying is even higher. You compete with all the platinum drivers, which are full on pros. That's not going to solve the problems that we have.
Hey, how's it going, dude?
Bad for you, it's bad for me. I have to be honest. For me, it's hard to say anything. For sure, I can give you, I don't know how many laps I did in total. 50? I don't know. It's tough for me as well. Honestly, I'm not happy at all.
Do you want to do the quali?
No. It's your turn. No.
Because I was talking to Richie about it. It's like, I don't know how much laps is going
to
help.
I have to be honest, I'm not feeling comfortable. And if I'm 1 second off, it's not me.
Well, all of a sudden we had to find someone who does the qualifying because Michael said, okay, we met that plan, but I don't think it's the best idea here. So the only person that was left was Richie. He basically went to the truck, suited up, got his helmet and jumped into the car with no preparation whatsoever because he didn't drive a single lap that day.
It's the first of two very special weekends here at Spa-Francorchamps with the European Le Mans Series in town.
Track temperature getting up there as well, 32 degrees.
Now, normally this would be a 10-minute session on any other track, but because it is 7 kilometres in length, the longest circuit we visited here, they get an extra 2 minutes. 12 cars in GTE. Now we've gained three because they are normally World Endurance Championship cars. So Augusto Farfus in the 98 Aston Martin is currently fastest. Ricard Leitz has done a 217.778.
Checkered flag is out.
93 Porsche comes out of the bus stop chicane, the final sequence of corners. Ricard Leitz does improve.
There was a quicker lap.
This is E1 for
you. Oh shit.
Richie qualified the car in pole position. That was even more pressure on his shoulders at that moment.
It's going to be interesting turn one.
What a fantastic start. He just obviously got pole here in the qualification.
We really pushed hard for this pole, and I'm sure Michael will enjoy starting from pole tomorrow.
I mean, for Michael, again, a new experience for him. I mean, it's for him, it's just to get used to all the new scenarios, new season, different cars, and now he's in the front, and I'm looking forward.
There was a lot of pressure at the beginning of the race anyways, because Michael didn't feel 100% comfortable, and then Richie qualified on pole position.
It's a good experience for me to be at the front, leading from the front, but to be honest with you, I knew it was going to be a short-lived experience. Just looking at the times over the weekend, I knew the guys behind me were faster.
The European Le Mans Series makes its annual trip to Spa-Francorchamps. We should have 39 cars ready to partake in the second round of the season.
Engine map zero.
And Michael Fassbender therefore positioned in the two-tone green Proton Competition number 93 car. This is the start of the formation lap. Two United Autosport cars at the front of the field. Michael Fassbender from pole position in the GTE category for Proton Competition. And round two of the European Le Mans Series is underway at Spa-Francorchamps.
Michael, very good start. Just follow the pack in front of you. Very good.
Michael Fassbender from pole finds himself third.
Oh, dear me. Safety car.
Yeah.
And a full safety car, not a virtual safety car.
In a safety car, all the gap you had before and all the advantage or disadvantage is gone.
People being disadvantaged by being caught behind the safety car in front of your own class leader and losing a lap.
So to get the cars in the order that they should be, there's a pass around.
So the cars eligible have moved to the right.
Okay, Michael, push. You can do a pass around. Go and catch the tail of the safety car.
Around they go to the back of the pack.
And then everyone can take their original position, as in where they were in the race.
Michael, keep pushing, pick up the pace if possible. You're almost there.
Michael Fassbender still desperately trying to catch up with the leading trio.
Okay, I'm at the back. Copy. Good, Michael, very good.
We all took our position correctly behind the safety car in order of where we were in the race.
I think even if the safety car is already in, we should do the stop.
Safety car in this way. Safety car in this way.
Hey, box or not?
Yeah, maybe. Let's do it.
Michael, box this lap. Box this lap. You stay in car
and you do a second full stint.
The team made a decision for me to go for a full stint after that to complete my hour and a half. We did a pretty quick pit stop and went back out, joined the race.
It's
So at that point, all we needed was a clear race, which was very important to capitalize on the strategy that we had taken. And we were really hoped for a green race without a safety car.
Second safety car. Now that's surely to recover the 60 Ferrari.
Slow down, we stay out, Michael.
And there will be no pass around behind this safety car.
Really? There's no pass around. So we lose a lap. Unbelievable.
What, there is no pass around?
We lose a lap.
Why?
Because he made the decision.
Was das denn? Kannst du also nicht das Rennen entscheiden?
In the rules it says it's up to the race director to give a pass around or not. Resulted in a loss of one lap and basically difficult to get any good result in this race. But in a championship like this, it's sometimes you win and sometimes you lose with a safety car. And this time we lost.
Richie was right on the pace straight away when he went out. And so it was pretty tense in the garage, watching Richie put like fast lap after fast lap. Then watching Felipe get in.
Felipe did not really feel comfortable in the beginning of the weekend.
It was not easy for me to jump in the car and to race.
55 up against 93 in the GT category.
The Proton competition, number 93 of Lazza. And this could get fruity because there's a prototype coming through this little battle. Matt Griffin doing a great job of driving his line.
Interesting.
Air temperature dropped down to just on 30. Track temperature dropping like a stone, 34.4. Oh, and lightning in the air.
Red tyres being prepared. No surprise there. Still very, very dark indeed and threatening. So a question of maybe when rather than if.
He's got miles off the track.
77, Jensen's in the wall. Lazza's on the fight back, so yeah, Lazza having caught the Ferrari, trying to keep him honest on the run down towards Eau Rouge, but the Porsche has got it. So 93 up a position.
Felipe didn't have much time either that race weekend, but he jumped in the car, performed amazingly.
How is conditioned, Felipe, of the track?
At that point, we knew we had to do something different and have to poker to have a shot at a good result.
Felipe, there is no more rain coming normally, so box this lap, full fuel, no tires.
We decided to stay on slicks, even though we knew it was a very risky call.
So an electrical storm having brewed up.
It's only a third of the circuit maybe that's affected by rain.
Good job.
He did the fast lap of the race right now.
With still 42 minutes to go, we're getting close. And Brundle still hasn't pitted. They're going to be really close.
88 drive-through.
Drive-through penalty for car number 88. That car's going to have to come out of third place. Close call. Isn't it? That's the leader. That's Michele Baresi. A huge moment.
So if you only look at the cars of ELMS, we're in P2 right now.
Now, actually, we were vying for a podium.
So very good job, Felipe.
We ended up getting second in the championship.
That shows again that endurance racing is just sometimes a roller coaster, up and down. And in the end, we ended up with a very, very decent result.
It was a tricky weekend, but I think it was a weekend where, as a team, we really got to know one another.
Dude, you're a rock star!
Rockstar.
Oh,
P2
is
the
last 5 laps.
Dude, it's great to watch. Both you guys.
You were struggling 2 days ago. Now you did an incredible race, very good. The traffic, because you had a lot of traffic. And we go back to Policar in 2 weeks, where you know the track already. So then you should go for a proper podium, you know, without the shoes.